Gastric bypass is an operation that's been around for over 30 years. It is really still the gold standard weight loss operation and involves cutting the stomach into two parts, one very small part, which is called the pouch, and the residual or remnant stomach, which is the rest, the other 95%, that's not going to be used for food after the operation. That small stomach pouch at the top is then connected to some intestine, and I can show you some pictures of that. The food is rerouted from the small pouch directly to the intestine without going through the bottom of the stomach. The intestine is then rerouted a little bit so that the food meets up with the stomach and digestive enzymes a little further downstream, so digestion begins lower in the intestine than it otherwise would have. During gastric bypass, again, 5 or 6 small incisions are made. The stomach is divided with a stapler into two parts. The intestine is also divided and one end hooked up to the small stomach pouch before the intestine is rehooked to itself. This creates a Y configuration where food enters one side, the digestive enzymes enter another side, and eventually they join together to begin digestion. So all those connections are done during the surgery through those 5 or 6 small incisions, and patients recover in the hospital for 2 to 3 days, sometimes one day, before going home. The advantages of a gastric bypass are that it's still the gold standard. It's been around for over 30 years. We know exactly what to expect, and it has one of the better weight loss results with about 70% of your excess weight. And at 10 years, we know people have maintained 50% or more of that excess weight loss. The main disadvantage to the gastric bypass is the vitamin and mineral malabsorption that comes along with it. So iron, calcium, vitamin D, B12, need to be supplemented and yearly levels checked to make sure that the supplements are being adequately absorbed. The other disadvantage is that it has a small risk of bowel complications long-term, bowel obstruction being the main one, or ulcers developing in the intestine. So it is an operation that involves not only rerouting the stomach and intestine, but also some absorption issues as a result of that. Gastric bypass is used especially for diabetic patients because in diabetic patients we see resolution or control of their diabetes in over 85% of patients. So if you were diabetic and severely overweight, you would probably be recommended to have a gastric bypass. It's also recommended for patients who want the most weight loss and the most long-term success, as gastric bypass seems to have better long-term success than a sleeve or a band. There's one other operation called a duodenal switch, which probably has as good, if not better, results than a gastric bypass, not most commonly done, but also available. Gastric bypass patients generally stay in the hospital 2 days, sometimes 1, sometimes 3 days, and generally 2 to 3 weeks at home to recover from surgery. The dietary advancement after surgery is pretty much the same as with all the operations. Liquid and pureed foods in small amounts, about 1 ounce every 15 to 20 minutes for the first week or two, advancing to soft foods in slightly larger amounts, and ultimately to solid foods. Gastric bypass is one of the easier operations to live with, as most foods are pretty well tolerated, but you need to stay away from sweets and fats. Sweets especially can cause symptoms after gastric bypass, something called dumping syndrome, which leads to discomfort, cramps, lightheadedness, dizziness, sometimes even diarrhea if you eat too much sweets. Well, gastric bypass patients lose about 70% of their excess weight. So if you're 100 pounds overweight, you can expect to lose about 70 pounds. Most of that should be maintained long term.